Welcome to This Week in Astronomy, brought to you by Celestron, the world's leading manufacturer of telescopes. I'm Dave Eicher, editor of Astronomy magazine, and this time we're going to talk about one of the great gems of the entire sky, the Orion Nebula. You may know of this object. It's one of the greatest star-forming regions in our part of the Milky Way galaxy that's producing, from hydrogen gas, a new generation of many, many young infant stars. You can see the Orion Nebula in different ways at all observational levels. It appears as the fuzzy star, if you will, in the center of Orion's sword to the naked eye. In binoculars, it comes alive and you can see it as a fuzzy patch with some stars involved. And in a telescope, if you get away from city lights, it's a playground of incredible delight in which you can see this enormous cloud. It's about 1,350 light years away, about 25 light years across this object, one of the great star-forming areas where hydrogen gas is coming down by gravity and creating new generations of stars. It contains some interesting features, several bright stars like in its center with a trapezium cluster, and associated fainter nebulae. M43 is adjacent to it, and a fainter patch of nebulosity, NGC 1973, 5 and 7. And these are the center, really, of an enormous cloud, the Orion Molecular Cloud, that covers much of that whole constellation where new stars are forming. It's one of the great playgrounds in our sky near us in the galaxy. So get your binoculars and your telescope, head out to a good dark sky this winter, bundle up, and see one of the greatest gems in our sky, in our part of the galaxy, the Orion Nebula. I'll see you next time.